The lecture that we are going to cover right now is syllogism. Syllogism is a type of, you know, reasoning questions which you'll see a lot on competitive examinations. So let's see what is syllogism all about. Basically, if we take a look at just the format of the questions that appear on the competitive examinations, you'll have statements and so on, and all you have to do is understand these statements, combine the logics, and create an inference or a conclusion. With these statements, you will be given conclusions or inferences. Okay, for example, C1, C2, C3, C4 and so on. Your job is to do this, then understand out of these conclusions which ones are correct, and then in the options choose the correct one that says, probably suppose in an example question, if you have C1 as the only correct option or the only correct conclusion, then option C, which supposedly is your correct answer, should say only C1 follows, right? So we have to choose that option which talks about only the correct conclusions from the given ones. This is going to be the way they'll be writing: only C1 follows, C1 and B1, C1 and C2 both follow, and so on. So this is the format. This is one type of format. There can be variations of the format for this. Okay. Now let's take a look at what syllogism basically means. Syllogism means that you have statements, and these statements have major and minor premises. Now, if we get into the details of the whole thing, then I'll be having to explain to you what are premises, what are arguments, what are conclusions and inferences. I'm not going to do that. Okay. What I'm going to try and do here is, I'll tell you some three basic statements which we will try and understand through common logic. So let's take three statements for the syllogism understanding. Statement number one says, I am a killer. Okay. Statement number two says, killers are bad people. Okay. Bad people are hateable. Okay. So, if that is the set of statements that are given to you, now what do you have to do? The first thing that you have to understand here is that whatever is given here, you have to assume it to be correct. Okay, even if they go on to say all birds are human, then by common knowledge you know that this sentence is incorrect. Still, for the sake of solving correct questions, you have to assume that this is true just in that whole purview of the question paper. Now, I am a killer, statement number one, assuming this to be true, and assuming statement number two to be true, killers are bad people. When I go on to say, I am a killer, killers are bad people, what do we infer from this? When I say, killers, I am a killer, killers are bad people, what do you normally conclude? I'll give you 1 second of time to think it for yourself. What do we normally conclude? I would normally conclude that Conclusion number one, I am a bad person. Okay? There can be different conclusions drawn, but this is the most basic one. Now, taking a look at statement number two and statement number three. Killers are bad people. Okay? Bad people are hateable. Now, conclusion number two states that killers are bad people are hateable. I just remove this from here and I say killers are hateable. Okay. Right. So if I say option, my option says, and let's suppose we have a conclusion like this. I am hateable. Now, can we deduce this conclusion? How can we deduce this conclusion? I am a killer. Killers are bad people. Bad people are hateable. Since I say killers are bad people, I become a bad person. I am a bad person. Bad people are hateable. So, I am hateable is also correct. Thus, we have three correct conclusions here. See, it's easy. All you have to do is apply your logic to the question. Now, I'm going to tell you something about the set theory, the usage of the whole circles in trying to understand or solve the questions of syllogism, the circles and the set theory. What does it really mean? Well, basically, for those who know a lot about set theory, you can skip on to around 3 or 4 minutes and look at that part of the video, or you can go and grab a cup of coffee. See, set theory, okay, is not gone into detail in syllogism. Rather, what they have done is they have just used the notation, the style of actually denoting the different sets in order to solve a question. Now, if I say that all birds can fly, okay, this is my statement number one. All birds can fly. Okay. Now bear with me and I say this to you. Suppose all of these are the birds in the world. Alright. Now I put them in a circle. Okay. The circle is full of all those birds that can that exist in the world. There is no bird that is in this world but not in this circle. Okay, so I cannot have something over here and still call it a bird. That is not going to happen. So it means that these are birds and I am representing them through a circle. Okay, if I say this circle here means flighted living beings or living beings that can fly. Okay. And I say all of these are the living beings that can fly. And outside of this circle, I don't have even one living being that can fly. Okay. I'm just representing all the living beings, just pick up all the species, put them together and, draw a circle around it and say that these are the flighted ones. Other than them, no one else can fly. Now, if I say that this is suppose, okay, let's just call them birds and let's call this flying living being. So, let's say this will be FLB, okay, the FLB circle. Now, if I say that these two circles intersect, this is intersection, okay. Now, if I go on to say that these two circles have something in common, okay? Other, you have two circles carrying a lot of stuff that they share or have in common, then definitely this is the kind of structure that we will be getting, okay? There will be points here, okay, which will be common to the BERT circle and to the FLB circle. What does this mean? This means that something that is a bird can also fly. It's as simple as that. Okay? Something that is a bird can also fly. But the problem with this is it does not match up with our statement. Our statement says all birds can fly. Now what does that mean? If I have birds here, definitely they are not in this circle. And those entities that are not in the FLB circle cannot fly. So this is not a correct representation of the statement. This is just a representation of the statement. The statement for this would be some birds can fly or some flying things are birds. Okay, simple. This is not complicated. I suppose this is very simple. Now, our statement will have to be represented by something like this. All birds can fly. This definitely means that if these are birds, then all of them can fly. So I have a bigger circle around it. Right? All the birds lie in the circle of flying, which means all birds present over here can fly. Okay, this means this. But there are different representations of this too. So, you know, sometimes you can have one circle and just one another circle coming exactly overlapping the whole circle. Okay, so don't get confused by the whole thing. Use your logic. It's simple, nothing else. In this, understand that there are entities over here. What do they mean? They mean that there are some flighted living beings which are not birds. Right? What it means is, this is an entity. It is not in the bird circle, but it's in the flying circle. Definitely, it's a flying living being, but not a bird. Okay? Lastly, we've seen the some thing, we've seen the all thing, let's see the none thing. These are the three most important parameters that are given in the questions. Some birds can fly, all birds can fly, let's say no birds can fly. How would we represent that? If I say no birds can fly, then I have a circle for birds, okay? And definitely that circle will not intersect with the flying living being circles. Okay? This is the representation. It's as simple as that. Two different circles, not intersecting, gives you the none kind of parameter. I hope this is clear. If it's not, you know, just rewind the whole thing, take a look at it again. Okay? We'll move on to a very simple example and then I'll ask you to move to the practice sheet. Now here, let's create the set representation for the three statements and then it will be very easy to just look at the conclusions. Okay, all pots are trees. Let's say this circle represents pots. Okay, and since all pots are trees, this circle has to be in a bigger circle that says trees. Right? All pots are trees. So this is your first representation. Now, some trees are green. When I say some trees are green, there are different ways in which I can represent this. Now, I know this is done in this way. Some trees are green. This is trees, this is green. How do I accommodate this thing over here? I'll say, if the circle green is represented this way, this is correct. Some trees are green, yes, but then there is another representation which can be done, because here if you focus only on trees and green, then this is correct. But you're forgetting that there is a relationship, or there might be a relationship between green and pots, right? So if we take this, if we draw this as a, you know, representation based on only these two statements, okay, we might just have an incorrect answer. So what you should do is try and understand what many different types of representations are possible. Put them all on your copy and then solve the question. Okay, so we have two representations here. Forget the trees part here. Then you'll see that this is one way of writing, you know. Okay, some trees are green, right? Which means that some trees are green, yes. Probably in this case, some pots are green too. But then there is another way of representing it. So I am negating myself. There are more than two representations here. Some trees are green. Can this be true? Now, the trees that are here are not green, but the trees that are here are green. Thus, some trees are green becomes correct. We can also have something like this. Okay, some trees are green. So in this case, again, some trees are green, but then some are not. Okay, this is another way of representing it. So you have many representations of the given statements. Thus, in order that this be correct, okay, in order that the conclusions be correct, all of the representations should be satisfied by the given conclusions. What I mean is, if I say all green are trees, then this, everywhere all green should be trees. Okay? But then we are not on conclusions right now, we still have statement number 3. Now statement number 3 says no green is a pot. Now this helps us a lot. From the representations that we have, no green is a pot must be true. So let's remove this. Now this one also goes away. Right? In these three, or rather this one also goes away, because you have green and pot circles intersecting. So we only have two representations here, which was my first conjecture. Now where are we? We have stated all three statements in the representation. Now we have to take a look at the conclusions. Some pots are trees. Now we have to check this. In both these representations, some pots should be trees so that this conclusion is correct. Some pots are trees. Okay, there are some pots that are trees. In fact, all pots are trees. Now if I say all pots are trees, does it mean some pots are trees too? Yes, it does. So this has to be correct. Now, no pot is a green. Now, no pot is a green. No pot is a green is also correct. All green are trees. All green are trees is correct here, but is incorrect here. Some green, which are here, are not trees. Thus, this one becomes incorrect. So you have two correct statements, C1 and C2, and you have one incorrect, which is C3. Now you go and take a look at the options. It says only C1 follows. This is incorrect because we know C1 and C2 are correct. Both C2 and C3 follow, incorrect. Only C2 follows, incorrect. None of these has to be correct. You know why? Because none of these options is correct. The correct one is C1 and C2 follow. So this is how you solve syllogism questions. Okay, you need a lot of practice on this. Go on to the practice sheet that we have. I'll just give you my best of luck.